Hi everybody and welcome back to Kingdom Wealth Creators. If you are here for the very first time, please remember to subscribe to this channel. Also remember to like this video, watch it till the very end and share it with your family and friends because I'm sure this is going to help all of them in their trading journey. A few days back on my community tab, I had posted that Shunya Beta is out and I will post a video on that. I know it's been a while, a few days now. But today, here comes that video and I'm sure this will make a big difference in your life because Shunya Beta is amazing. We're going to compare it with Zerodha's Kite once again. We're going to look at how the user interface is so good. And of course, when you combine it with Finvoicer's free brokerage, it's like heaven on earth when it comes to the brokering system. So let's dive into the video. Let's see what Shunya Beta holds for us. And I hope you watch this video till the end and you enjoy it. So this is the new page for Shunya. This is Shunya Beta. You can see the shunyatrade.finvoicer.com. And just for a difference, I can show you that this is the previous page. This is the previous page that was existing for Shunya. And you can see that there's a bit of difference when you look at the... All right. So this is Shunya, the older version. This is Shunya Beta, the newer version. Now you can... either enter using your PIN or you can enter using your password and your PAN or date of birth. Let me do this and entering. All right. So now I told you that it looks a bit like Zerodha and that is what I want to highlight here. But it is very clean. You can see here. Now, when you get to your dashboard, you can see what your margin, available margin is, what your credits, utilization, all of that. You can see how many positions you have open, what's the P&L for the day, what's the total P&L on those positions, what's the MTM for the day. So this P&L is the total profit and loss for the entire positions that are open. The MTM is what's going as the, what's the profit for the day. And those are only on future positions. All right. Now you can see orders, whatever orders you want to buy or sell, those are there. So now again, this is way better than Zerodha. If you can see here, you actually, when you enter your orders, they will show up here. Once they're done, they will show up here in the trade book as to what are the specific timestamps and orders that you placed in. But if you want to see what are the closed orders, you can see it over here as well. I've already done a few trades today morning. Position wise, you can see all the positions that are open here. You can adjust it this way, that way, whatever. You can download it. You can exit a chosen position. There are multiple ways. Even if you click off here, just like Zerodha, you have depth, your chart, your conversion from MIS to normal, whatever. You have the exit, you add positions. So it looks pretty much like Zerodha. It is as fast, very stable, and I'm really impressed by that. Your holdings will show all the holdings that you have and the overall profit and loss. If you remember, the market had crashed for a while, 10% down, and still my holdings are holding up impressively. I closed a lot of my profitable positions, a lot of the positions that got hit hard, I'm holding them. This is will show you entire holdings. You can actually toggle between BSE and NSE, though the BSE won't be that clear because I don't have any positions. You see, it's just this is what we do. Now you come to the margins play page. This is again much better than Zerodha because here you can see what your collateral holdings are, what your opening balance is, and you can see in one quick window, you can see all the positions that are available. Total credits for the next day is basically the options that you've sold. So all of this, is in a very clear format. Under markets, you can look at screeners, analysis, all of that. And here's a cool thing that I noticed, okay? If I were to click the chart, right? This will take me to a chart. And I actually have options even on the charts. Okay, you can do all of this just because this is straight from TradingView, by the way. And to make this even clearer, let me pick up something that is SBI, for example. Let me quickly pick up SBIN and there you go. And if I click the chart, I actually have the option to switch from, which chart I want. So for example, chart preference, I can change this from Chart IQ to TradingView if I want to. So that's something that is really impressive. I don't think that's available on Zerodha, I'm not sure. But that's again, really impressive. You can set alerts, you can create basket orders, all of that. You can even do IPOs on this. So everything on one single window. See, to apply for an IPO on Zerodha, you have to go to the console and all of that. This is cleanly, very clean. Even the the number of tabs available are pretty much like Zerodha. So there's 7 now on Zerodha, 5 here, but I'm pretty sure they will add this. Here's something that else I noticed, really cool. Okay, you can see that these are two main references. So normally on Zerodha, if I were to show you, it would show me, Nifty and Sensex, but I can't change these. But here I can change. If I click this, I can put up the India VIX, or I can put up the Nifty. I can change whatever I want to make it. I can make it the Nifty of 500. So this is really cool. I realized that this is not something that we normally see on Zerodha, but here, this is really cool. And you can just look at the options available, all those options available. If you want to put it on Sensex, which is the actual normal available indicators on Zerodha. Okay, it's NSE, Nifty 50, and Sensex. But here, you don't have to be, you're not restricted by that. You can actually choose even the Nifty band, which is what a lot of us also look at. So this is pretty much the position. So what I would like to say about Zerodha is, before we would say that, the Kite or the Zerodha Kite GUI was really cool, and it still is, but now Shunya has made it the same. It looks pretty much the same and very much closely aligned to the Zerodha Kite GUI. So in terms of the user interface or the graphical user interface, they are pretty much the same. But in terms of options, the way you can modify this and make it your own, the Shunya beta is way better than Zerodha Kite, because you have a lot more configurations that you can play around with, and that makes it better. I wouldn't get all of these informations in one shot on Zerodha, but here I can see it very clearly, and that is really great. And lastly, of course, the USP of Zerodha has always been the zero brokerage. So now you combine the same UI, which is on Zerodha, to Shunya, and you have a Kite-like platform, Shunya Beta, which is really powerful, really quick, very stable, by the way. I have done this under stress. The last week, when the Nifty was moving all over the place, I was under a lot of stress, and it did not give up on me at any moment. I'm so glad that you watched that, and I'm hoping that you enjoyed and learned a lot from that video. I am using Shunya Beta and it is amazing. I have put it under a lot of testing even during the volatile last few weeks, and it has stood the pressure, and I would recommend it to anybody and everybody out there, because you can enjoy both parts of the world. Thank you so much.